स्टूडेंट्स, सो आज के इस वीडियो में हम एक जेई मेंस का बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन करने वाले हैं, डेफिनेट इंटीग्रेशन का। सो एग्जैक्टली क्वेश्चन क्या था, माइनस पाई बाय 2 से पाई बाय 2 डीएक्स डिवाइडेड बाय ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर ऑफ एक्स प्लस ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर ऑफ साइन एक्स प्लस 4। सी स्टूडेंट्स, जब भी हमारे पास ये साइन होता है, ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर फंक्शन, ये पहली बात होता क्या, व्हेनेवर यू हैव दिस साइन, सो दैट मींस यू हैव टू टेक द ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर ऑफ दैट फंक्शन। लेट अस सपोज दिस इज 2.56, सो एनी नंबर इज बेसिकली अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ अ इंटीजर एंड अ fractional part. If I talk about this question, 2.56 is a combination of an integer 2 plus a fraction of 0.56. So that means whenever we are asked to tell the greatest integer, we are interested in the greatest integer of that function. Let us suppose अभी अगर question होता है 9.9998, So, इसका ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर भी 9 होता है। लेट अस सपोज वी हैव क्वेश्चन -3.46, इसका ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर -4 होता है। दैट मींस वी अंडरस्टूड दैट द ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर फंक्शन टॉक्स अबाउट द ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर फंक्शन। If we talk about the graph of greatest integer function, it comes out to be like this, that we have already seen in the chapter function. So that means it is also called step function. And you know, basically this function, greatest integer function, is discontinuous at all integral points. So that means we need to find the integration of this problem where this function becomes a problematic situation for us, that is greatest integer function. Now how to solve this problem, I'll just tell you. First of all, these were the basics when we talk about a greatest integer function. Remember, a number can be written as in the form of greatest integer and fractional part. So, coming to the problem, the question is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, and this is an integrable function which is given to us. First of all, let me tell you, when we talk about the integration sign, definite integration, minus pi by 2 will be coming out to be approximately 1.57 and pi by 2 is coming out to be 1.57. That means minus pi by 2 से pi by 2 के बीच में जितने भी integral points हैं, उस पे ये function, greatest integer function discontinuous होगा. So that means directly I can't integrate this function. That means we need to take the help of the properties of definite integration, and we have already studied integral a to b f of x dx. If it is discontinuous at some point c, then we break the integration into two parts, integration a to c f of x dx plus integration c to b f of x dx, in which these two functions become continuous and we integrate and solve the integration function. So similarly, if you see from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, minus pi by 2 is minus 1.57. So from minus pi by 2, the integer which comes next is minus 1. So we will just break this integration from minus pi by 2 to minus 1. Alright. So after this integration, the next integer which comes is minus 1 to 0. After this, let me just rub this part. नेक्स्ट इंटीग्रेशन विच कम्स इज 0 टू 1 एंड टुवर्ड्स द एंड वी हैव 1 टू पाई बाय 2. अगेन आई एम टेलिंग यू द लिमिट्स, द लोअर लिमिट इज माइनस पाई बाय 2 एंड द अपर लिमिट इज पाई बाय 2. सो वी हैव ब्रेक दिस, वी हैव break this integration into four parts where it was becoming discontinuous. So from minus pi by 2 to minus 1, this will be the one integration. Minus 1 to 0, this will be the second integrable function. Then again from 0 to 1 and the upper limit which is given to us is 1 to pi by 2. Now we can solve this integration very easily. Just see, when x is from minus pi by 2 to minus 1, what is greatest integer of x? It will be, you know, greatest integer of minus pi by 2. That means when you will be putting minus pi by 2, it is minus 1.57. So the greatest integer of minus 1.57 will be minus 2. So this greatest integer of x will be changed to minus 2 plus. When you will be substituting minus pi by 2, when the x value will be between this, what will be the greatest integer of sin x? So it will be minus 1. Okay. So this greatest integer changed to minus 2 and this greatest integer changed to minus 1 plus 4 as it is. Understood? Similarly, when your dx will be lying from minus 1 to 1, again we can solve it like this. When it is from minus 1 to 0, what will be the greatest integer? Minus 1. Again, plus this will be minus 1 plus 4. Okay. In the next step, tell me what is the greatest integer?
1.
It will be when x is lying from 0 to 1, the greatest integer will be 0 itself. Again, for greatest integer of sin x, it will be 0. So it will be 0 plus 0 plus 4. And tell me for the last, what will be the greatest integer of these two functions when x will be lying from 1 to pi by 2? So from 1 to pi by 2, greatest integer will be 1. And greatest integer of sin x will be 0 plus 4. Again, I am telling you, I have just divided the integration into its integrable form and I have substituted the value of greatest integer. So in the first step, it was minus 2 plus minus 1. In the second step, it was minus 1 plus minus 1. In the next step, it was 0 plus 0. And in the last step, greatest integer will be 1 plus 0 plus 4. Now, this becomes very easy for us to solve. If we will be solving it, this integration will be changed to minus pi by 2 to minus 1. And this will be calculated to dx divided by minus 3 plus 4 is 1. Plus integration minus 1 to 0 dx divided by 2 plus 0 to 1 dx divided by 4 plus 1 to pi by 2 dx divided by 5. So see, this problem changed to a very simplest expression which can be evaluated easily. If you will just evaluate this expression, this is coming out to be minus 1 plus pi by 2. Second one will be half is outside. So it will be 0 plus 1 plus this will be 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5. And upper limit is pi by 2 minus lower limit. Alright. Okay. So, once you solve this, this is coming out to be minus 9 by 20 plus 3 pi by 5 plus 3 pi by 5. Okay. So after solving this, you are coming to the answer, which is equals to a reduced form of this definite integration minus 9 by 2 plus 3 pi by 5. If you see the expression, so it is not in this form, that means you need to do some simplification. Just take out 3 by 20, which is common. So it will be 4 pi minus 3. If you will just see, this will be 3 by 20, 4 pi minus 3, which will be option B. So students, from definite integration, let me just tell you, the properties of definite integration are very, very important. All the properties that we discussed in the class, do revise it for the JE mains and the upcoming examinations, JE Advanced and BITSAT. Thank you so much.